What is Earth for you? For me, is the only home in the universe. In Earth, there's living things. There's also not living things, like rocks. Earth is a beautiful place. You could find a beautiful wonder in there. We really need Earth because it's the only planet we know that has perfect air pressure, perfect weather, perfect everything. And the reason why is because Earth is located in the perfect position in the universe. It's not too close, it's not too far from the sun, and that what makes life possible on our planet. So we also need to take care of the Earth. Just like I said before, Earth is a beautiful place. But also, there's a lot of wrong and ugly things happening right now. Violence. Wars. Pollution. Oil spills. We just got one in Houston at this time. And droughts. And the list can keep going on and on and on. I don't know about you, but don't you feel sad when you see these images? Hello, my name is Rebecca Moreno. I'm in third grade with Miss Woods at Hausman Elementary School. I really like to take care of the nature. I also love animals. Last year, I did make a video about Earth Day 2013. And this year, as you see, I'm making another one for Earth Day 2014. The main reason I'm doing this video is because I want the children of my age to be aware that our planet is being damaged by the grown-ups. And the scary part is that we, the children, will be facing the consequences of all the damage that the adults are doing now. Remember, Earth Day is not about celebrating. You got to do something about it. Earth Day is on April 22nd, 2014. On this part of the video, I will show you some ways to save the planet. One thing to do, save a tree. Use both sides of a blank paper when you're using a notebook. Sometimes I draw. And when I'm done with one side, I use the other side. Chopping down a tree is a problem, but the worst is when you don't plant a new one. So when you chop down a tree, plant a new one. Plant a seed or a tree. When you cut a lot of trees, this causes a deforestation. Wildfires also cause deforestation. Don't do any activity that may cause wildfires. Trees take several time to grow. In some cases, it could take hundreds of years. We need trees because it gives us oxygen by something called photosynthesis. Second thing to do, save water. When you wash your car, use a bucket. Don't use a water hose. Also, use a bucket when you're taking a shower. I know it's not comfy when you use a bucket, but it's good when you save water. How do you brush your teeth? Use a glass of water instead. It will save water. Third thing to do, do not litter and save energy. This is a true story. Every time when me and my dad go to the park, we always see this trash or littering. And sadly, there's trash cans around. What people need is conscience. Littering is same as pollution. Pollution is to bring something to the nature that is not supposed to be there. Littering is bad, but there is something worse than that. Chemicals on the air or on the water. Air pollution reduces rainfalls and causes droughts. Take for example, Africa in 1970. Search for the biggest drought in the 20th century. Africa drought was on the past. Do you want to see our present? Search for California drought. It's happening right now. And here you'll see some before and after picture taken by California Department of Water Resources. This is a before picture. And down here is the after picture. The before picture was taken on July 20th, 2011, and the after was taken January 16th, 2014. And as you see, under the bridge, there's no water in the after picture. These two pictures are pretty shocking. I mean, there's a lot of water in the before picture. How we stop pollution? Walk if it's a short distance. Share cars with other people. Use bikes if it's safe. Turn off lights when you don't need it. Turn off your TV and go outside to see wonders of nature. Things like fossil fuels should be no longer used. Also, there are other harmful things like drugs, cigarettes and garbage that cause major air pollution. But the most important thing, think on ways to use energy that does not use fossil fuels. One day, I saw this lightning storm and an idea came to my head. Do you have any idea how much energy is inside that lightning? A lot! My idea was to use lightning energy instead of fossil fuels. I don't know how, but I will find a way someday. If we don't care and do something about any of these goods, we could lose our only home. Remember, Earth Day is not just about celebrating. You got to do something about it.